This is Brett, and in this video, we're going over self-administered hip mobilization techniques. Now, this fills a big gap in our exercise selection, that is, our self-administered exercise selection, as we move from just looking at muscles in dysfunction and optimizing human movement to start looking at arthrokinematic dyskinesis and how we can improve the way those joint surfaces move against each other. I'm going to have my friend Melissa come out. She's going to help me demonstrate these techniques. Now, I do have to give a shout out to Kelly Sterrett for some of the innovation behind these techniques and the use of these monster bands, as well as my friends Aaron Swanson and Pete Schultz over at Dynamic Sports Physical Therapy for showing me some of their modifications. And then, of course, I got my little twist on stuff based on what I think is happening at the hip. Now, the compensation pattern, the arthrokinematic compensation pattern that generally happens at the hip is the femoral head moving superior and anterior in the acetabulum. Now, in order to correct that, I have a couple options. I can start pushing back posteriorly, which we're definitely going to show you that technique, although this is where those practical problems come in. That technique doesn't work as well just for issues around the exercise itself. The other thing that works really well, though, is a lateral distraction. So a lateral distraction for the hip joint is a very general distraction that will help aim at those posterior and inferior capsule fibers that have adaptively shortened. So, how do we do this? Well, we got to get a band around one leg, and it's got to be one of these thick monster bands. You guys try to do this with a resistoband tube, and it's gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt a lot. All right, so we take a thick band. We got to put it all the way up against the inguinal ligament, right? All the way against that bikini line, and then we're gonna flip into quadruped position, making sure that this band is pulling directly laterally. All right, and go ahead and adjust the band. Oops, sorry, I stole your pad. Now, notice I got a couple Eric's pads set up here. It's because this technique's a little rough on the knees, so get them as much padding as they need to make sure that their kneecaps feel okay. Now, once she's in this position and she's got a good amount of tension on that band, remember the hip joint is a big joint. We don't want to pull them so far that they think their hip is going to pop out or that there's going to be pain, but they need a good amount of pressure to get those fibers around the hip capsule to stretch out a little bit. Once I get her here, all I'm going to have her do is rock. Right? And when she does this little rock, I want her whole body to rock, and I want to make sure she's pushing with this glute. Right? So it is her left glute that's pushing her into a position. And that way I get a little gluteus medius activity out of this too. I definitely don't want her pulling with this leg and gearing up her adductors. Chances are if she has some lumbopelvic hip complex dysfunction or lower leg dysfunction, hence why I'm doing this exercise, those adductors are already a little geared up. Once she's done this, I know she knows how to find center. I know she knows how to put pressure on the band. She's good at these oscillatory techniques. I see that she's getting some benefit from 15 to 20 repetitions. We can start taking this up a notch by doing lateral distraction with some osteokinematic motion that can start working on flexion or start working on extension. Usually I'll start with working on flexion if that's where the restriction is. So I'm going to make sure she's moved to center. She's got good pressure on the band. She can actually kind of look between her knees, and what I'm going to have her try to do is sit back on her feet nice and center. The thing you don't want them to do is to lose all muscle activity, and then you can come back up, lose all muscle activity and just fall into their feet, because they'll shift with the band and there won't be any tension on their hip. All right, so she's just going to sit back, keep that tension, keep center, and then come back. Now, as I discussed in the other self-administered mobilization video we did, there's a couple ways we could do this here. We could go back and forth through this nice, large osteokinematic motion, or let's say she was stuck at 110 and had no pain. Well, I could just do that 1 to 2 oscillations per second for 30 seconds right there in that little tiny area, just kind of going up against that stiffness, just like the mobilization techniques we learned in school. Or let's say she was somebody who had a little bit of impingement and a little bit of pain. Well, if that was the case, I would only have her go back as far as she could pain-free. Maybe just touching into that pain a little bit and then coming back out of it. Remember, I don't want to exacerbate pain. I don't want to exacerbate the inflammatory process. And all of a sudden she gets up from this technique and she's got a limp because I just made her pain worse. I want to improve her arthrokinematics. So even just doing this through her pain-free range is gonna help. Now after that, we can get really, really fancy. And we can go all the way from flexion of the hip, right, keeping center. And then she can start working on a little bit of extension with lateral distraction by going from child's pose to that modified push-up position, squeeze her glutes, get all the way down into hip extension, right, and then go all the way back. She does 15 or 20 of these with that nice lateral distraction, and you guys will see a lot of that stiffness alleviated. Once again, if I thought she was stuck in one position, I could work in that range, but usually by the time you got somebody here, you're just cleaning up the very last bits of that arthrokinematic dysfunction. Now the next technique I want to show you guys is every once in a while somebody with like hip impingement or a really stubborn hip flexion restriction will get a huge benefit from a self-administered anterior to posterior mobilization. And then I'll explain why this doesn't work out as well as this technique does. What she's going to do is she's going to straighten herself out so that the band is now pulling her femur that way. She's going to stay in this quadruped position, but this time I'm going to have her get out as far as she possibly can, assuming that there's no pain. She's going to keep up the band nice and high. All right, can you get out any further or no?
No.
Good. All right, so sit back. All right, and you guys can see I have a nice anterior to posterior hip mobilization. All right, the only problem with this isn't where the maximal tension is, which that would be nice, but that's just not how bands work. So we can go ahead and have her work a little bit on, let's activate her glutes with that anterior to posterior mobilization. But then as I go back to where I really need the tension, it's actually backing off. I don't want to say that this technique doesn't work, because it absolutely does work and I absolutely do use it, but you guys can kind of see how just the practicality of this exercise, I don't use this one as much as that lateral hip distraction, which works wonders. It really does. I find that the carryover I get from manual techniques done during a session is incredible for all of my PTs, ATCs, and DCs out there. And for my personal trainers, you can try these techniques a little bit. And I think for those of you guys who've been working on your corrective exercise strategies, it'll help get you to that next point. Now, it would make sense that from this position that I could progress to like a kneeling or half kneeling or even a standing lateral hip distraction or AP distraction. You can go ahead and sit up. I don't want you to make yourself Gumby today. It would make sense that I could get into this half kneeling position or maybe a standing position, but what I find is that as soon as I don't have all points on the floor, all four points on the floor, rather than this being a hip mobilization that actually distracts the hip, it starts just kind of being resistance, right? So if I'm in a kneeling position and it's pulling this way, it doesn't pull my hip out before I just shift. When I have all four points down, I think there's enough restriction in the body. You're creating enough friction with the floor that mobilization happens first. Something for you guys to work on, something for you to try. So now we got a couple new mobilization techniques. We did the ankle in the last video, hip in this video. I think knee is coming up next. I hope you guys get great outcomes using these self-administered techniques.